We're going to spend a bit more time discussing on the issues of how we have adulterated food by introducing chemicals, especially pesticides, you know, that have been linked to chronic diseases, diabetes, the blood pressures, the allergies, and of course, unfortunately, cancer. I can tell you, without fear of contradiction, that is partly why some of us have diseases, that is partly why some of us have cancer, including breast cancer. It's so simple. We have adulterated food by taking it from the garden to the lab. God did not create food to be tinkered with or twerked. In the lab, we have introduced chemicals. Chemicals are for doing lab experiments in the chemistry lab. They're not for putting inside food. In simple English, the Europeans have found that our farmers are spraying the food with these dangerous chemicals, and the level of the residues is not acceptable for them. So since they know that it will cause disease, they are saying you either reduce the levels of these chemicals or please mshukatuletee chakula hapa kwetu, do not import or rather export that food into our contents. Why? They know that those residues of some of these chemicals, including glyphosate, can cause disease. But when these seeds of food is eaten and gets into your stomach, it basically damages the bacteria, what you call the probiotics, the bacteria that allows your body to produce amino acids and I don't know how, but you know that one. But basically, it causes gut dysfunction. This is why if you ask your colleagues around, probably including yourselves, many people these days are suffering from all sorts of shida za matumbo. Whether you have cancer or your blood pressure or diabetes or blah, blah, blah. A lot of GIT issues, gas, discomfort, leaky gut, celiac disease, Crohn's disease, tons and tons of them. You know what's happening? This imbalance in the gut system, number one, is being caused by these chemicals being in food. That's number one. Number two, this particular chemical chelates some essential micronutrients like manganese, like iron, like sulfur, and so on. So essentially, it robs you of the good nutrients and creates an opportunity for the proliferation or the multiplication of this bad bacteria like Clostridium botulinum and others, blah, blah, blah. Well, number two, cytochrome 450 enzyme. These are often enzymes that you need for you to synthesize essential amino acids like tryptophan, tyrosine. I don't want to go into my chemistry. When these chemicals block those enzymes in the liver from doing their job, autism, Alzheimer's, depression, and finally, causation of chronic conditions, including cancer, and ladies and gentlemen, including breast cancer as well. Believe you me, including for cancer survivors or victims, is exercise. Please, exercise, 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 day and night. Yeah, and that exercise includes all forms of exercise, including sex, as long as you have it with the right person. Hello, you are adults.